In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you 7 cracking signs of a great relationship. 7 signs a man is healthy for you and you should not be letting that relationship go. Hit the subscribe button with the little bell and don't forget to grab a copy of my book. Link in the description. You can get it right now. It's tremendous. I'll see you for the signs right after this. Seven signs your relationship is healthy for you. So if you're in a relationship right now, these are signs that I've found over the years signal really powerful and healthy relationships for my clients. And if you're not in one right now, then have a listen to these and start to think, okay, have I felt these with different people before and how can I bring these together in my relationship in the future? Number one, you don't feel like you have to do anything to keep his interest. What a powerful and healthy relationship sign where you really feel someone is there for you, rather than what you can do for them, right? This means you can enjoy yourself in the moment with him. This means you feel totally accepted for who you are by him, which also means you can learn to accept yourself even more. And it means that when you do things for him, you're doing them because it lights you up to do it. It gives you more energy to do something nice for him. It makes you feel more loved and loving to do something nice for him. You're not doing it through fear or obligation or because you feel like he will love you less if you don't do the thing. When you're in a relationship where you feel like you don't have to do anything to keep his interest is just there by default, just for you, for who you are. And that is a massive sign your relationship is uber healthy. Number two, you always, 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 always feel respected by him. So I spoke about this in another video. I'm reiterating it here because it is such a healthy relationship sign. Mark Manson, one of my favorite authors, check out his stuff, did a big, big study of over 1,500 couples. And what he found was that in these 1,500 couples who had all been married 20 plus years, was that the number one thing that kept them together was not communication, was not even kindness, but was respect. When they were together, when they were separate, when they were going through tough times, when they were going through great times, the common factor was they would always respect each other. So if you always feel respected by him, especially when things are not going so well, when maybe you guys are a bit annoyed at each other, or when there's just a bit of a negative dip in the relationship, if you still always feel respected during that time, that is a wonderful sign your relationship is healthy. Number three, big one, super healthy. You're not confused about his interest. This one really speaks for itself. And so many clients who come to me, women who come to me, it's confusion over interest. Does he like me? Is he into me? Why won't he commit? He does this. He's so warm. He comes towards me. Then he pulls away. I don't hear from him for a week. So much confusion. Okay, what is a world of confusion? If you're spending all your time, you know, especially if you're spending months or years in these situations, you're going to be spending months or years confused, right? If you're spending months or years confused about someone's interest, you're going to be spending months or years starting to feel confused about why you're not good enough or what's wrong with you. That's where we go back into the child mindset, where if we didn't have the best upbringing, we start to wonder what's wrong with us. Well, the same thing's gonna happen if you're in an adult relationship where you're feeling confused about someone's interest. So if you're in a relationship where no matter what happens, whether you're taking a bit of space, whether you're a bit annoyed at each other, whether you're having a great day, whether you're having not so great day, that no matter what happens, you know that guy loves you. There's no question of his interest. If you're in a relationship like that, that is a powerful sign your relationship is very healthy. Number four, your self-confidence is higher than it used to be, even when he's not around. So codependence, that means you're basically enmeshed with him. That means your confidence or your self-worth relies on him. So if he goes down or if he's not around, you're not going to be able to bring that confidence out. But interdependence means that you can have your confidence, you can still lean on that person, but there's healthy boundaries in between, and you'll notice this because you'll know when you move away from him, when he's not in the room, when he's not physically around, you look at yourself and you say, wow, my confidence has actually gone up as an individual. If your confidence is going up, if your self-worth is higher, if you're more, taking more chances, if you're doing more things, more self-belief, that is a wonderful sign that relationship is healthy. Number five, your body insecurities have lessened or eliminated in the relationship. So we talk a lot about loving ourselves, and it's true, the more that you find love for yourself, the more you're going to find that reflected in a man. But no one's perfect. And you don't have to unconditionally perfectly love yourself to qualify for a relationship, right? You're going to have insecurities. You're going to have things you don't love about yourself. You're going to have things that you might not like, especially when it comes to your body. But it's cool because in a great relationship, this can work the other way. So you'll notice that sometimes when you're in a great relationship, you might have those little insecurities, but the man loving them and accepting you for them actually means that as an individual, you accept them more in yourself. This is something I noticed in myself as I went through good relationships, was that things I used to be insecure about with one woman, when she totally accepted them, in my next relationship, that was just something that I owned. Right? It was no longer an insecurity. So if your body insecurities have lessened, if you're feeling more accepting of your body, more confident about your body while you're with someone, that is a wonderful sign your relationship is healthy. Number 6, you're not afraid to show any interest in him, right? How often do we hear the advice, play hard to get, treat him mean, keep him keen, stay away? And it's true, sometimes in the short term, that can generate attraction. But what the hell do you do after that? What are you gonna do? Play hard to get once it's your boyfriend, once it's your partner, once it's your wife, you're just gonna keep being avoidant to attract the avoidant guy? You can't fake this, right? So in a healthy relationship, it's not weird to show interest in your partner. You can do it whenever you want. You show interest, you want to give them kisses, you want to say I miss you, you want to do all the things. They're normal and it's not weird for either of you to receive that interest from the other. What this really communicates underneath is that you are comfortable with your independence during closeness. And when it comes to someone who's avoidant or a man who's emotionally unavailable, what that at a deeper level really means is that when a woman, when you move close to them, they start to fear that loss of independence and they move away. But in a healthy relationship, you can give each other compliments, you can move closer, and it doesn't become a threat to your independence. You have confidence in your independence in closeness. That is interdependence, and that is a wonderful sign of a healthy relationship. Number 7, there is a wonderful friendship underneath your chemistry. So often in popular culture, and just even in ourselves, we can get distracted by the sexual chemistry, by the energy, by the connection. But could you hang out with that person all day without sexual vibes at all? Would you want to do that? Would you consider this person one of your best friends? The mark of a great relationship is that you can go from that sexual polarity, that masculine feminine polarity passion, to equal friendship model. This is a best friend. This is someone I respect. This is someone whose values I admire. This is someone I'd want to spend a day with, even if there was no sexual chemistry that way involved. If you have an amazing friendship underneath the chemistry where you guys can talk about anything, you can hang out and it's not weird. This is someone I'd want to spend my time with. Wow, that is a wonderful sign of a healthy relationship. And the 7th sign of a great relationship to not let go of. Hey, don't forget to grab my book. It's wonderful. Grab it from the description. Put your comment as well. I'd love to hear about your healthy relationship sign. If you're in a relationship, tell me what's healthy about it. I'd love to hear it. If you're not in a relationship, what's the big thing, the big healthy piece that you're going to make sure you get in the future? Pop it in the comments below. Hit the subscribe button with the little bell, and I'll see you in the next video very soon.